Last week, we talked about linear combinations. We've just defined what a linear transformation is. We're now going to combine those two, and this then will allow us to link linear transformations to matrices. We defined a linear transformation as a vector function that has the special property that if you scale first and then transform, or you transform first and then scale, you get the same result. And if you add two vectors first and then transform the result, you get the same result as if you first transform the individual vectors and then you add the result together. Now, what this particular lemma says is that there is an alternative way of defining a linear transformation. It says that L is a linear transformation if and only if, no matter what vectors U and V you pick out of Rn, and no matter what scalars you pick, if you take the linear combination of the vectors using those scalars, and then you transform the result, you get exactly the same result as if you first transformed the vectors, and then you took the linear combination of those result vectors. Okay. Now, if and only if is sometimes written with this funny symbol. The way you often prove an if and only if is that you first show it one way. In other words, we're going to show that L is a linear transformation implies that if you have any vectors U and V and Rn and any scalars alpha and beta in R, then this result here is true. And then next, what we're going to do is assume that for all U and V and Rn and scalars alpha and beta, this result here is true, and use that to prove that then L must be a linear transformation. And that would be the part of the proof that goes the other way. Let's have a look. So we're first going to prove it from the left to the right. We're going to assume that L is a linear transformation, and then we're going to choose U and V to be arbitrary vectors and alpha and beta to be arbitrary scalars. We're going to start by first taking the linear combination of the vectors and then transforming it. And then we're going to prove that that means that you can first transform and then take the linear combination. Now, how does that work? Well, we know that alpha U and beta V themselves are vectors. We know that if you add two vectors and then transform it, you get the same result as if you first transform and then add. So therefore, we can conclude this right here. And notice that we give the justification for the step right here. We also know that L is a linear transformation, and therefore we know that if we scale first and then transform, we get the same result as if we transform first and then scale, and the same thing for beta times V. Notice that that proves the result that we wanted. We wanted to show that this was equal to that. Then we have to prove it the other way, which means that we're going to assume that this is true for all U and V and all alpha and beta. And we now want to show that L is a linear transformation. How do we prove that? Well, we need to prove that if you first scale and then transform, you get the same result as if you first transform and then scale. And we also need to prove that if you first add and then transform, you get the same result as if you first transform and then add. The first result follows by choosing your beta to be zero. Notice that we're assuming that for all U and V and alpha and beta, this here is true. Therefore, we can pick a specific beta. And if we pick our beta to be zero, then what you're left with is that this goes away and that goes away, and you're left with exactly the result that we want here. Okay? Similarly, we simply say, oh, we want to prove that we can add first and then transform, and that that's equivalent to saying first transforming and then adding. All we need to do up here is choose our alpha and our beta to be 1, and we get exactly the result that we want. So that proves our lemma.